Hey guys, I'm Saurav. Welcome to the channel. This is the second episode of the series Color Grading Explained. Now, in the first episode, we talked about tone curves and I explained why tone curves is the most powerful editing tool according to me. In this episode, I'm going to talk about HSL panel and I will explain why HSL panel is the best tool, especially for color grading. If you want to learn how to color grade your images, HSL tool is the must learn tool. Again, this video will be a very detailed video. You will learn a lot of different things that you didn't know before. I'm very excited. Hope you too. So without wasting any time, let's get started. The HSL panel stands for Hue, Saturation and Luminance. First, let's talk about saturation because that is easiest to understand. For that, let me go to the basic tab and adjust the saturation. As you can see, when I'm increasing the saturation, the intensity of the colors increases. And when I decrease the saturation, the intensity of the colors decreases. So saturation is nothing but just the intensity of the colors. When you increase the saturation, the image gets more saturated, and when you decrease, the image gets desaturated. Very simple, right? The problem with the saturation slider in the basic tab is when you're adjusting the saturation, all the colors are getting affected, right? See, the blues, the greens, the yellows, everything is getting affected. What if I only want to target a particular color and adjust the saturation separately? That is where the HSL panel comes into play. So, when I go to the HSL panel and in the saturation tab, you see different set of colors, right? Now, if I increase the saturation of the greens, only the greens are getting affected. If I change the yellows, only the yellows are getting affected. This is reason number one why I like to use the saturation slider in the HSL panel. Reason number two is the small pointer option that's available here. So if I take the pointer and if I just click, I can see the color. So this is yellow, this is green, this is blue, purple, whatever it is, right? Even you can tell what color it is. So why is this particular small pointer option so useful? The reason is when it comes to photos or videos, a color is actually a combination of different colors. So for example, here the trees are the combination of yellows and greens. And you don't have to guess if any color is a combination of different colors. You can just use this particular marker and when you change the saturation, as you can see, the yellows and greens are automatically getting affected. I don't have to select the colors manually. The pointer option is able to do it for me and we will be using this particular pointer option throughout the video also for luminance and hue. So I hope you have understood what saturation is, right? It's basically the intensity of the colors. Now, let's talk about luminance. Now, luminance means brightness, and that's exactly what it is. Luminosity of colors means the brightness of colors. For luminance, let me open this particular image. Whenever there's a blue sky in my landscape images, I tend to decrease the luminosity of the blue color to get a deep, dark sky. I'll show you what I'm talking about. Let me go to the luminance. Again, let me decrease the luminosity of blue color and as you can see, now this is too much, but as you can see, I have decreased the luminosity of the blue color and there's too much contrast and drama in the sky. Now let's use this pointer marker and decrease the luminosity and as you can see, even the aqua is getting affected because this sky is made up of blue and aqua, but I didn't have to do that guessing part. The marker does that for me. Now, you can obviously reduce the luminosity. I won't do it too much because then it looks fake. Maybe just about minus 50 for blue and minus 25 for aqua. That looks good. And as you can see, just by decreasing the brightness of the blue color, we are getting much more details in the highlights. Again, you can do it for different colors as well. I use the pointer marker option. I can make the grass darker or brighter just by changing the luminosity of the respective colors. I hope you understood what luminosity is, right? It's a very simple concept. You're just changing the brightness of colors. I use this luminosity tool also when I'm editing a black and white image. Let me just convert this image into black and white. And as you can see, instead of the HSL panel, I only have a black and white mix panel. Basically, this is the luminosity panel. I can adjust the luminosity of the blue color and only the sky is getting affected like before. Now the question in your mind will be, Saurav, if the image is black and white, how does Lightroom know that the sky is made up of blue color? And the answer for that is, the original file has all the color information stored in it. Even if you have converted the image into black and white, since the original image has all the color information stored in it, When you're changing the blues, only the blues are getting affected. When you're changing the greens, only the greens are getting affected. Let me just make the greens a bit darker, and let me just make the blues a bit darker as well. Again, I will reduce the aquas as well. Just with these three adjustments, you have converted a colorful image into a wonderful dramatic image. Just by changing the luminosity, you can adjust the contrast, you can change the drama, and that's why it's such a powerful option. I also use luminosity when I'm adjusting skin tones. Skin tones are often made up of a lot of oranges and reds. So what I do is first, I just go to the pointer marker so that I don't have to guess the color. I just reduce the saturation a bit. And then I can increase the luminance a bit or decrease the luminance according to my preference. I can just increase the luminance a bit. And as you can see, just with simple saturation and luminance, I have fixed the skin tone. So I hope now you have finally understood how to use saturation and luminance for your images. Now, finally, let's talk about hues. Hue is basically gradient of color. Now I know 100% that you did not understand what I said, because even I did not, frankly speaking. So for that, let me open Photoshop. I'm opening the color picker option in Photoshop, and as you can see, I've selected H. Again, H stands for hue. And as I'm changing the hue value, the color is getting changed, right? Basically, hue value is a value that determines what color you're choosing from this particular gradient of colors. So when you're changing the hue of a color, you're not changing the saturation or luminance, you're actually changing the color itself. Now, how to use hue for color grading? For that, let's go back to Lightroom. So in this image, the water is made up of blue and aqua. Let's only adjust the blues first. When I increase the blue of the When I increase the hue of the blue, as you can see, it looks more like purple. When I decrease the hue of the blue, it looks more like aqua. Now, how to understand by changing the hue of the color, which color is it shifting at? It's a very simple trick. See, let's talk only about blue here. When you're increasing the hue, it's getting shifted towards the color below it, and that is purple. When you're decreasing the hue, it's getting shifted towards aqua because it's the color above it. To make it more clear, let's see the color picker option of Photoshop. As you can see, as I'm going below, we are going from red, orange, yellow, green, aqua, blue, purple, magenta, and again red. So I hope you have understood what hue is. Let me color grade an image for you guys from scratch with the help of HSL panel so you understand it in much more detail. This is the image I'm working with. Now the question in your mind will be, Saurabh, what do you adjust first? Hue, saturation, or luminance, and what is the correct order? The answer is, there is no such correct order. It all depends on the image. For this particular image, I want to change the luminosity of the sky and the grass. That's why I will use luminance first. Then I want to change the colors of the image. That's why I will go to the use tab. And then I want to change the intensity of the colors. So I will use saturation. This is the order for this particular image. The order will change depending on the image, as I said before. First, let's go to the luminance tab. I want the sky to be a bit darker. I will just reduce the luminosity. I will do a very rough edit just to give you an idea. I will make the grass also a bit darker because I want a darker feel to the image. Maybe I'll just reduce the luminosity of the sky just a tad, and that's it. I'm happy with the luminosity. Let's go to the use. Now, I want the sky to look more like aqua. That's the color grade I'm going with. So what I will do, I will just go here. I will reduce the hue of the blue color so it looks more like aqua. Now, I want to change the colors of the grass. I can make this particular green look more like yellow, or I can make it look like aqua. For this one, I'm going for the aqua look, so I'm shifting towards the positive side. As you can see, since aqua is below green, I'm using a positive hue, so green is getting converted to aqua. And just with simple luminosity and hue, we have already changed the look of the image. For the final result, what I will do is I'll just make the sky a bit more saturated. I will just decrease the greens a bit, so that I have this saturated sky and desaturated grass and a unique look. Again, this is a very rough color grade, but I hope you have got an idea. Just by changing hue, saturation, and luminance, as you can see, we have changed the look of the image completely. If you have a final result in your mind, you just have to visualize that particular final result. Now you know how to adjust hue, saturation, and luminance. You just have to visualize and adjust those settings accordingly. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and if you did, make sure you press the like button. If you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe for more such amazing content. I'll talk to you guys in the next one. Bye.